Six facts about the periodic table. Number one, the creator of the periodic table, Dmitri Mendeleev, was inspired by solitaire when he created it. In the game of solitaire, cards need to be sorted by suit, numerically. He made cards of the 60 known elements and wrote the atomic weight and properties of the element on each card. Then he began his advanced game of chemical solitaire. He stacked elements according to specific properties, which is similar to the suit in solitaire. Then he arranged them based on atomic weight and made a table of them. This is how the periodic table was made. He later said, "I saw in a dream a table where all elements fell into place as required. Awakening, I immediately wrote it down on a piece of paper. Only in one place did a correction later seem necessary." Number 2. Element names refer to six different ideas. The first one is a mythological concept or character. One example of this is in the element titanium, which is named after the mythological characters. Another example is being named after an astronomical object, like uranium was. When uranium was discovered, Uranus the planet was discovered at a similar time. This is where the name of uranium comes from. Elements can also be named after a mineral or similar object, like lithium was. The name comes from the Greek word lithos, meaning stone. This is because lithium was discovered in a solid object, like stone, instead of plant tissue, like elements discovered around the same time were. Elements can also refer to a place or region, like californium. Californium got its name because it was synthesized, or created, in the State and University of California. Next, elements can also be named after their properties. This goes for the element hydrogen. In Greek, hydro means water and genus means creator. The combination of these words creates hydrogen, or water former, because water is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. Finally, element names can refer to a scientist. A common example of this is einsteinium, which is named after one of the greatest scientists, Albert Einstein. In conclusion, element names can refer to a mythological concept or character, an astronomical object, a mineral or similar substance, a place or geographical region, a property of the element, or a scientist. Number 3, J and Q. The lonely letters do not show up anywhere on the periodic table. The letters cannot be found in any of the chemical symbols or in the names of any of the elements. Here are the other 24 letters of the alphabet found in chemical symbols of elements. These elements are osmium, magnesium, xenon, tungsten, curium, krypton, zinc, dysprosium, livermorium, iodine, lead, hafnium, and astatine. Number 4. Liquids and gases. Of the 118 elements found on the periodic table, only 13 of them are either liquids or gases at room temperature. The two liquids are mercury and bromine. They are the only elements that are liquids at room temperature on the periodic table. There are 11 gases that can be found on the periodic table. These are hydrogen, helium, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, chlorine, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. The other 105 elements found on the periodic table are all solids. Number 5. Guessing the elements. When Mendeleev created his periodic table, he left empty spaces in the periodic table. This is Mendeleev's original table with the empty spaces marked in red. At the time, these elements were unknown. However, since he arranged his table based on the properties of the elements, he was able to guess their properties. These elements were scandium, gallium, germanium, and hafnium. As you can see, the atomic weight in the original table is very similar to the corresponding weights on the element card. This is one of the main reasons people in the scientific community accepted Mendeleev's periodic table. Number 6. Lanthanides and actinides. The reason the lanthanides and actinides are at the bottom of the periodic table is to save space. There is a 32-column periodic table with the lanthanides and actinides inserted, but as you can see, people prefer the other table as it saves space and fits better in a textbook. Thanks for watching 6 Facts About the Periodic Table.